This is the world's most powerful rocket taking off. And this is it exploding shortly after. After years of development, SpaceX's Starship and its super heavy rocket with its 33 Raptor engines finally got airborne in April, for a short while at least. Now, while SpaceX has launched hundreds of spaceships, it's Starship that the company hopes will become a rapidly reusable gateway into space. But while it may have taken years to get even to this point, it's actually just the very beginning of Starship's long road to carry humans to another planet. So what's the journey ahead for Starship, and what will it take to get there? SpaceX say the idea behind Starship and the Super Heavy is to be the first fully reusable space transportation system, where both the spaceship and the rocket powering it can be used over and over again. One of the most prominent missions for Starship will be to carry astronauts from a spacecraft orbiting the moon down to the lunar surface and back as part of NASA's Artemis 3 moon landing missions. I caught up with WSJ's space reporter, Micah Maidenberg.
NASA awarded a nearly $3 billion contract for the Artemis 3 moon landing. That's currently scheduled for, you know, sometime in 2025. 2025 is coming up pretty quickly. For SpaceX, it's a very high profile and intense objective that they have to reach.
SpaceX is also planning on using Starship to carry cargo into space, whether that be the company's Starlink satellites or fuel for other starships. And SpaceX CEO Elon Musk has also said that one day he hopes to use Starship for a mission to Mars.
But building something this complex that's fully reusable isn't exactly easy.
As Musk said at WSJ's CEO Council in 2021,
man, Starship is a hard project. It is so preposterously difficult that there are times where I wonder whether we can actually do this.
So, what did we learn from the launch?
Well, while there have been some tests of Starship before, this is the first time it's been powered by the massive Super Heavy rocket system. And the company wasn't exactly sure how successful the launch would be.
If we lift off and clear the pad, we're calling that a win.
Things seemed to be going well for the first few minutes, although it appeared that some of the Raptor engines were out. The Super Heavy rocket also failed to separate from Starship. And then... However, the launch will have left the company with a trove of data.
You know, one of the main goals of this flight was simply to get information. The way SpaceX historically has operated is when it learns something, it uses that to try to quickly make changes, improvements, to iterate.
So what's it going to take to get Starship from this to this? Well, SpaceX will need a lot more test flights, as NASA's moon mission could be as soon as 2 years away.
Gwynne Shotwell, the company's longtime president, said a couple months ago at a conference, she wants to fly a lot of flights with Starship, starting with the company's own Starlink satellites, because they need to figure out what this vehicle, what this machine can do.
One thing that's almost certain is that NASA will be watching those flight tests closely. The agency has said they're not going to use Starship to carry humans until there have been successful tests, and that SpaceX will conduct an uncrewed demonstration to the moon prior to the Artemis missions.
So in a way, right now, then one of the big next steps for the Artemis program is for SpaceX to show that it can operate Starship the way it's like laid out to do.
So while the launch might have been one giant leap for Starship, it's just one small step for SpaceX.